So in this video, we will learn how to style text in LaTeX and some of the sizes, text sizes available to us in LaTeX documents. There are three basic styles which we use normally. One is called bold text and italicize text, and then the typewriter style text. So this is a sentence and we want this to be bold. So there is a command called backslash text bf. And then we can insert this text within the curly brackets and this will be bold. Similarly, to italicize a text, which is also called emphasize, so you can put a command which is called text it. So this will italicize the text whatever you want within the curly brackets. So this much text will be italicized. And then in typewriter style, you can use the command text tt. And then put the text which you want to be in a typewriter style, and this will be in a typewriter style. So if I compile this now, you can see that the styling has been applied to these three sentences. So the first is bold, then the italics, and then the typewriter style. So if you want some other sizes, so there are a lot of sizes available in LaTeX. So the biggest size which we can use without using any package is called huge. So if you want some text to be in huge size, so you put huge with a capital H. So this is huge size. So let me put this here. So this is the largest size available in LaTeX. And after that, if I just copy this few times, so I will show you what other sizes are available. There are a lot of sizes available to us, and we don't have to use any other package for getting any other fonts, because there is so much variety. So after this capital huge, we have a huge with the lowercase h. This is also available to us. So just put backslash huge and then whatever text you want. And after that, we have large with all capital letters. Then we just, let me change this as well so that we can see the difference. And then we have large with L capital. This size is available. Then large with all lowercase is a little less than large with L capital. So you can see whichever size you'd like for a particular application. And then there is a normal size. If, for example, you have changed to large or huge and then you want back to your normal size, so then you use this command, normal size. So normal size text is also available. Then after the normal size, these were all the large category in decreasing order until the normal. And then we have the smaller category starting with size small. Small size is available. And after small, then we have a footnote size. Footnote size command is available. Let me change this so that we can see the difference. So footnote size. And after footnote size, we have two further sizes available. One is called script size and the other is called tiny, which is the smallest size available. So I just copy paste this twice more. And this is called script size, which is a less than the footnote size. And normally you put all the subscript and exponents in this size. And the smallest size is tiny, which you, if you really want a very small text somewhere in a figure where there is not much space available, then you can use the tiny size. So let me compile this so that you can see the difference in these sizes. So as you can see, that this is the largest size and this is the smallest size. So a huge variety is available to us. So there is normally no need to install any extra packages. You can select one of these sizes and one of these styles for all of your applications. And normally this is enough for text styling and sizes. I hope this will help you style and size your text.